The shallowest of the potentially multiple magmatic intrusions ongoing on Iceland's Reykjanes Peninsula has been discovered to already be at only 4 kilometers depth, creating some potentially scary news for Halloween. This intrusion is centered 1,500 meters west-northwest of the peak known as Torbjörn, which could spell a major disaster if it was to reach the surface and erupt. First off, such an eruption could cause lava to flow towards the Svartsengi geothermal power plant, a 76-megawatt power plant that supplies about 3.6% of the entire nation's electricity and the popular tourist attraction of the Blue Lagoon. Lava flows could not only damage the plant, but also evaporate much of the water used to generate electricity. Also, if the Reykjanes volcano did eventually erupt near its current uplift site, sections of the town of Grindavik could be placed at risk. In the last 10,000 years, lava flows have covered sections of what is today Grindavik 3 times and its outskirts once, last occurring in 410 BCE and 1240 respectively. As a result, while no evacuations have been ordered as of October 30th, there is already an evacuation plan in place that will likely be ordered only if an eruption occurs, which I have linked in this video's description. However, there are discussions currently being made to possibly implement large dirt and rock barriers like what sometimes successfully halted the advance of lava flows from Fagradalsfjall's last 3 eruptions. And, if this eruption did occur, it could cut off sections of roads 43 and 425, making traveling around to certain parts of the peninsula take much longer than beforehand. To understand what might happen next, a quick look back at the last 15,000 years of eruptive activity can help us guess where lava might flow if an eruption did soon occur. Rather than consisting of a singular central vent like a typical volcano such as Mount St. Helens, the Reykjanes volcano consists of dozens of fissures, some small shield volcanoes, and spatter cones spread across an area of 440 square kilometers. Generally speaking, no singular vent has erupted more than once, although there may be a few exceptions. In the last 15,000 years, land-based eruptions of the Reykjanes volcano have occurred 9 times, covering 232 square kilometers in volcanic rock and sometimes ash during this time span. And, unlike the 3 eruptions which have occurred from Fagradalsfjall since 2021, there appears to have been a minor explosive component in a little less than half of Reykjanes' geologically recent eruptions, which have rated as high on the Volcanic Explosivity Index as a 2. Generally speaking, it appears that the further to the west an eruption from this system occurs, the more explosive it gets. Based on known data, the 2 closest eruptions that occurred to the current Reykjanes uplift center both had a volcanic explosivity index of a 1, so something similar could be expected if an eruption does occur. Of these 2, the 1240 eruption is the best match to the current uplift site, although its vents are centered 2 kilometers to the west, so it is not a perfect fit. In that eruption, more than 40 vents erupted along a 6,300-meter-long stretch of land, encompassing 9 distinct fissures over a period of several months. While such a lengthy and voluminous fissure eruption appears unlikely in my opinion at Reykjanes, we can use the topography and path this eruption took to predict where lava from a hypothetical Reykjanes eruption might flow. Given the current uplift site, here are several areas where lava could flow into based on my analysis. In my opinion, the southwestern section of Grindavik would be at the highest potential risk as the region's topography would naturally direct lava flows in that direction. There is still a very good chance that a volcanic eruption won't occur at the Reykjanes volcano in the next month, as the vast majority of magmatic intrusions fail before they reach the surface and erupt, as something similar occurred via magmatic intrusion at Fagradalsfjall in late December of 2021, which failed at only 900 meters depth and did not erupt. With this being said, the current 4-kilometer deep intrusion appears to be the shallowest of the 5 magmatic intrusions and also the one with the fastest rate of uplift this system has generated since the beginning of 2020. I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.